when you want to act as the young leader and do something for your local community, you're supposed to build a network around yourself, people that are eager to help you and actually can share experience and can support you on every step. Okay, so thank you for this part. Now I will share the second presentation. It will be about European projects. Okay. You can see?
Yes.
Okay, great. Thank you for the confirmation. So as I said at the very beginning, we are part of Eurodesk network. We are a regional office in Opole, is the city in on the south of Poland. And I want to share with you my knowledge about the how to join the programs and some basic information, how does it work like. But I suppose that you are already on youth exchange, you already have some knowledge, but I hope it will be helpful for the future anyway. A little bit of agenda, some objectives, how to join, where to find the offers, and some program details, what you can expect during those kind of programs. First, Erasmus Plus. Youth exchanges are for youth, and thank you, European Union, that you can see that youth are until 30 years old people. So it's great, for example, for me as the student, that I still have time for going for the youth exchanges till this age. But also each of group has the group leader, and those kind of people have no age limit. So you can invite everyone, for example, even the teacher, even the parent. But I don't expect that you would like to go with your parent for youth exchange, to be serious. And also, it could be the worker of non-governmental organization. For example, as the worker, I can go with the group, thanks to my experience. Then, program in the numbers. When you think about the mobility, it's like from 5 to 21 days. But actually the project is longer. It's important information for the organization that it's the time when they need to prepare you as the participants to join the youth exchange, and also the time for dissemination of effect of your work. So when you finish your mobility, your meeting in Poland, then you will probably come back and write on Instagram, Facebook, some relation from your meeting. What about the group? It could be maximum 60 people, so a lot of people from around the world. I don't really know how many people are on your youth exchange.
28.
Less than 30.
Okay, so also really nice group, probably not as many as 60 people, but nice to work with each other anyway. And what is provided? As you can see, you already had provided accommodation, transport, support from the organization, because as I can see, Wojciech is there as the host of youth exchange, but also when you were in your country, in Romania and Latvia, there was probably the partner organization that was informing you how to join, what kind of step you need to fill to join this this mobility. And usually this is what I do in my work. When I have the group and I want to send them for the project, I do culture preparation, some language preparation, the meeting about insurance, the transport, and so on. So it's included in this support of Erasmus Plus. And the last one is Youth Pass, really great certificate that you can get from European Union. And it's useful when you want to apply in the future, for example, for work or for university, Because from my own experience, it really matter, because it's showing up that if you, even if you have no experience in work, it's showing up you've done something extra in your free time, and you have you gain experience from different kind of situation than work, but it's still useful. And finally, where do you find the offers? I don't know where you find the information about your project, but of course you can find it on Eurodesk website. I put here Eurodesk Polska, Poland, but the European website also have the tab where you can find the opportunities. I will show you when I finish the presentation. Of course, the social media, usually Facebook, Facebook groups are the perfect place to find the offers about projects, because organizations are informing widely about the actions. It could be also the information office, for example, as our regional office, sometimes the youth are coming here and I'm telling them where they can find the offers, or I already have proposition for them. And of course, it would be also the information face to face by the network. If you already know someone who went abroad, they probably are interested and in such the information, and then they will tell you, for example, do you want to go with me, for example, to Italy? So this is kind of way how you can find the offers. And finally, the websites of the organizations, also on social media. If you are already follow someone who is really engaged in Erasmus Plus program, so probably the organization is putting a lot of offers on their website. So after this project, you will probably follow the social media of this NGO, from Romania, Latvia, and from Poland. And the topics. You are here today probably in the topic of participation and in democratic life, common values and civic engagement. But what I wanted to add, you can talk about those topics in unusual way, because of course you can create the normal workshop, debate, see how the other organization is working in such the topic. But what I want to share, for example, you can use the culture. You can talk by the theater, creating the theater about European values. This is something you can imagine. But if you have the topic that is not included in those priorities, it doesn't mean that you cannot offer another topic. I know the organization that is making the meeting about the games. They are creating board games. So if someone is interested in that, it's also a possibility to get the money from European Union for those kind of topic about the cinema, about, I don't know, about sport and so on. There are a lot of opportunities that you include in this program. So here is some screenshot from our youth exchanges in Germany and Georgia. They were about eco projects. So as you can see, there are many options. And actually, the nice part of those youth exchanges was that they were cooking together and they were preparing the dishes by themselves. So it was also a nice part of integration between the groups. And then I have the European Solidarity Corps. I believe this is the program that maybe you didn't hear about this. It's focused on volunteering programs. You can join it to live abroad for 2 months, 1 year, few months. It depends what kind of project you will choose, because we have long-term project and short-term projects, and you can go individually or in group. This program is supporting youth in gaining experience and learning some competences and also supporting local communities. Just imagine that, for example, you want to go 1 year abroad, and this program is providing you everything, money, accommodation, mentoring, and so on. And your task is helping to organization to create their own activities, or you can create your own project, but it could be connected to your interest, or you can find the topic that you have no experience, but you want to try in safe space if it's something for you. I will later show you up what I mean by this by those responsibilities as the worker. But first, I want to talk about the basics things that program provides. Who can participate? It's only for adult, but it's still in the criteria of youth. So you need to be between 18 and 30 years old and be the citizen of European country or partner countries, but then you need to apply for the visa. And it's only for registered candidates, but it means that you need to find the offer on the European Youth Portal and register there. This is the only one thing that you need to fill at the very beginning to join the program. But moving to what he's providing, this is really great opportunity because European Union gave you everything actually, accommodation, transport, insurance, you have money for food and also pocket money for your needs. If you want to buy some souvenirs, you want to go to the club, European Union is giving you money for those activities in your free time. You also have the language course and you have mentor from the local community or coordinator from the organization that you are living with. And also you are receiving the youth pass after this project. So once again, this is the confirmation you gained some experience, some competences. And what is most important, when you're going for this kind of project, you are not worker. Volunteer is working shorter during the day. And for example, my organization is hosting the girl from Ukraine. And Alina is helping us by her skills because she is the photographer and has a lot of experience in movie making. So when we preparing some events, she's coming as the photographer. But of course, she's working shorter and can be can enjoy the event as the participant, for example. It could be the project about working with children in primary school. It could be the project about creating music festival. So there is a lot of option. It only depends what kind of organization is inviting you. I can give you the example of my friend that she's working with me. She went for 2 months to Greece. So imagine summer, living in Greece island for free, and she was making the events for people, for the local communities that were living not by the sea, but inside the island, to invite them for the integration, and they were cooking food for them. But in the free time, they could enjoy their life on the Greece island. I think it was Lefkada. So there are many options. I heard about the project when you could work with dolphins. You could participate in Croatia in the event. Sorry, I need to find the word in English because in Polish it would be easier. It's ships racing for the sailors, you know, They were swimming by the sea, and they were preparing the events for the sailors, for example. So there are a lot of topics. But going back to the information how to join, I already said that you need to register on European Youth Portal. You need to create the account there. But on the other side, there is responsibility that belongs to the organization that is looking for the candidates. Because when you register, they can find you as the candidate, or you can write to them that you want to apply to the project. And then there is a presentation of the... Tak, coś się dzieje, czy...
A zostało nam 10 minut spotkania, ale tak. To nic.
A to, jest, to już jest, to jest końcówka. Aha, bo macie tego Zooma bezpłatnego, o to chodzi, dobrze. Dobra, to staram się.
Mamy 9 minut jeszcze.
Dobra. Sorry, I heard we have a short time, but we'll start the meeting once again. And coming back, when organization is inviting the candidates, usually there are a lot of people. When I was making the recruitation for the project, we had almost 50 people, and I had to talk with each of them to see if they are ready to go to join the project in Poland. And it looked like that you are invited for the interview. And it's not really like the job interview, it's mostly to find if you're really ready to join the project. Because it's living 1 year abroad. For a few people, it might be the first experience abroad. So it's also a challenge for some people. We need to check if they can communicate in English. You don't need to be expert in English. You don't need to be really fluent, but it's at least basic of English. Because sometimes there are people that they just send the application, but they don't speak English at all. So then it's a problem because they cannot communicate with you actually. But also during those interview, we are checking if the experience or expectation are equal for both sides. If this person is ready for the task that we can offer, and also if we are ready to meet the expectation of those people. For example, if we have a candidate who wants to develop in the frame of social media, I need to be sure I have the worker or someone in my organization that can be the great support or the inspiration, the mentor for this person to help develop the skills that this person wants to develop. So this is the example. But of course, when this person filled the process and we invited this person after interview, it's preparing the documentation, this person is joining us and is living with us in the organization, supporting us during our work. But it doesn't mean this person is staying alone, because to join the project, you also need organization that will send you from your country. So for example, when we have Romania, we need the organization from Romania to send this person, and the worker is supposed to be in the contact with a person that was sent to Poland, for example. This is the part of the evaluation and taking care about well-being of this person that is living abroad to make sure everything is okay. If this person is feeling okay in this country, in this organization, because of course it might be the challenge that you can meet with some organization that don't really follow the European instruction or rules, but it's really, this is just the example, it's not happening very often, but as the workers, we are responsible to take care about the evaluation and well-being of people that are using the opportunities from European Union. And basically, that's it. About where you can find the offer, once again, it would be the same the same websites and the same options like with Erasmus Plus. One extra is only this European Youth Portal, where you can find the information. Here there are some screenshots from the offers. This is the one in Poland that people like the most, because this is the project is every year. They're looking for the people which will be pick up little turtle from the beach and put them into the sea. And later in the free time, you can enjoy living in Turkey. And also this is the offer from Greece, when a volunteer could help the office in organizing workshop with young people. So for example, if youth exchange would come, they would help their organization with, I don't know, taking photos, making the relations from social media. So this is a great opportunity to gain experience in safe safe space. For example, it's good to go after high school, before university, to try if the work you want to follow or the path you want to follow is really for you. I think it's a great plan for the future for you, actually, because now till 2027, European Union gain a lot of money for next projects. They expecting that over 270 people, thousands of people will join the program. So a lot of people from European Union and partner countries can join this program and develop their skills, competences, and find the plans for your future. So here is the bibliography. I also have some questions for the discussion, but maybe if we have some time left, you have actually the question to me. So I will just stop sharing the presentation. And for the last thing, I prepared the websites where you can find the information about the opportunities. This is main Eurodesk website. Here there is the tab connected to opportunities, and actually here Eurodesk opportunity finder, and there are offers from entire Europe. Actually, it's only you need to choose what kind of activity you are interested from what country, and the age of group. We have a similar on the Polish website. We could join by weź udział. It means join, participate actually, and it's working in the similar way. And also, as I mentioned, there is European Youth Portal. There is the tab Go Abroad, and you can find the volunteering project.